I was an extra.
Disclaimer: the actions performed in this video are for informative entertainment purposes only. Do not try anything in this video. That's,
Guy.
yeah, oh, you've seen it. Yeah, of course.
Detroit numbers levels running.
Oh.
Here in Florida. Hunting the penguin.
I just want you to take me to the nearest gas station.
Okay, no problem.
Tampa is one of the most dangerous cities in the world. We've already gone over some of the most elite self-defense techniques, and today we brought out the expert. We're going to be doing it in an interesting fashion. So it's going to be the three of us participating in the formal training from Dale of the Detroit Urban Survival Threat Management Group Turbo Mode. I'm basically the worst participant, so this is beginner level. This is intermediate. Rex has formal training in every martial arts on the planet, special ops, secret forces. So basically, if I'm coming at him, it's going to be defending against a middle schooler. Caleb, probably like your average criminal. And then Rex,
Average
you're getting hunted by
criminal.
the boogeyman. That's ultra nightmare mode. So
Level
we got
99
Dale here. We're going to
criminal.
really put him to the ultimate test today.
Detroit Urban Survival Training, here in Florida.
All right, so you
Wonder if
want to
it's fully
spare
booked.
the Glock then?
Probably fully
Let's do the
booked.
Glock.
Okay.
Start with the Glock. This is a real Glock.
So, for all you volunteer ATF agents, there's a chamber flag. This is a real gun. However, comma, you got no live rounds here. Everybody's been checked. No live rounds in the
No live
building.
rounds.
This chamber flag actually goes into the barrel, so you know there's nothing in there. Stick my finger in there. You want to go ahead and check it?
This homie 100%. I mean, he's doing like ATF beams and shit. This is one of Charlie's friends. He's
Yeah, he knows his shit.
an interesting guy already. I
She's
can
friendly over there.
tell.
Oh yeah, she's empty.
All right.
So we're gonna do
Bro, look at Charlie's response. Oh yeah, she's empty.
Oh yeah, she's empty.
All right.
Very good. Good opera, good
So we're
opsec.
gonna do what we did in our video. We're gonna start with assailants coming at you. And since it's Florida, maybe
You
they're a
have to
little
stick your
under the
finger in
influence
it?
of bath salts, so they're a little wacky. They got the gun at you. How do you get out of this situation? They don't want to just bargain, they want to kill you. So it's
Okay.
disarming them, getting away from them. It's going to be me and Caleb doing it, then Rex, and then after
Okay.
that, we'll try and do it to you, employing
Okay.
techniques.
All right, take your weapon, Charles.
Give me the.
And go stand.
Why did they use a real Glock instead of like just the fake
Yeah,
one?
airsoft gun
Like
or something.
over there and face
It
down.
gives to the,
Authenticity.
yeah, it gives to the
So
immersion.
this way, right?
Brother?
Yep.
We're about to unsafe
That's
handle.
Charlie's sovereign citizen friend.
Handle.
All right. Where's your kids?
Whoa!
Okay.
I'm blinked.
So you
Oh
know
my
you
God.
wood fire. Okay. Try it.
Okay.
Same thing.
Your kids.
Yeah, it did fire.
Right.
But when it fired, I was off to the side.
Takes take two
So
steps
the reason
back.
why is because when I saw the weapon coming, I stepped offside, offline, and redirected. And that's when he actually
You
fired. So
refrigerated the bullet.
he already made the decision to fire as soon as it came out, which does happen.
Okay, Charlie, take two steps back.
Oh, there we go.
And then,
Now what would happen?
yeah, so for
Look at his shoes, bro.
Dude,
I
he's
love Charlie so
ridiculous.
much. Look at this fit. This is the most.
The white tee with the Nike short.
He's got
Ooh.
The signature white tee. He's got the longest Nike shorts. I mean, so long.
Knee level.
Okay. At knee level. The most Florida man on the planet. This is the Florida man uniform. Okay. He's wearing those like Skecher ass shoes. I don't even know what this is. Classic Florida drip with the backwards cap.
From
Yeah,
here,
you're
I'm,
Florida.
yeah, that's what I was wondering. So if I'm coming at you and I'm like showing and I'm like
Yep.
down here,
Florida's prepared.
but I have so much time.
Yes, and I would get shot, probably.
Yeah.
But because I'm going forward, I'll probably not get shot a lot. Whereas if I
Sure.
went backwards, I would.
Wow, that's cool.
Okay.
Okay, well, what do you mean? I'll get shot, but not a lot. Oh, okay.
You can take a couple.
I mean, I don't know. It's like urban survival training, more like, you're still dying there. Urban survival dying, but not by a lot of bullets.
Probably get shot more. what you're doing, everything you do when you're disarming or whenever you are defending yourself, is either increasing or decreasing your likelihood of survivability.
And then if I'm back,
yeah, so got one shot in. Yep, you got shot at least once.
We did like a grand.
It's not about getting.
Hey, sorry to hit you with this greasy jump scare. I just wanted to quickly say that Dale was very honest and openly admitted that when there is distance between attacker and victim, you're just going to get shot if you try and fight back. So we didn't do more of these scenarios where we had distance on the victim, nor did we simulate like running away while shooting, because it's the same situation, which Dale openly concedes. You will just get shot. If your attacker gets distance from you or already has it, you're just going to get fucking blasted if you try and fight back. So we didn't simulate more of those. Going forward, we only simulated the scenarios where the attacker was right up in the victim's nutsack.
Oh, you get in there. Let's take it to the next level.
Next step up.
This is the one we got 139. We have 133 million views right now on this one, which is the gun is to your chest.
Yeah.
And what this is for is you have to get contact with them.
Oh, God.
You have to get contact. And you have to make sure they don't go away. Otherwise, they'll just run away from you. Or they'll pull out a gun or a knife. So you go like this. And that's how you get their stuff. You take things from them. And the other reason they do this is because they don't trust you. So they're not going to sit there and go, empty your pockets. I trust you. I'm not going to touch you because I'm scared you'll take my gun. Criminals are not scared you're going to take the gun ever. They don't believe. You can even tell them I'll take the gun. They're like, I wish you'd try. Go ahead and try to take my gun.
Oh, wow. I tried. I really did.
It was right here. And the guy puts the gun here.
Wait, but like, okay, but he pulled back, which is like kind of the magic bullet to... The killing Detroit Urban Survival Man is always just
back it up.
Just back up and then fire. You know what I mean?
Is that his counter?
Yeah, it's Dale just proved that grabbing the gun is dumb. Except he's an expert. That's why he's able to tactically pull the gun away last second, whereas others can't.
Use it.
Wow,
he's so fast.
Oh, shit. Oh, he pulled the trigger with my own finger.
That's for GSC. That makes sure there's gunshot residue on your hand, not on mine.
What?
Damn.
That's so dumb. You 100% would have gunshot residue regardless. No. If you are shooting him with his own finger, you are going to get gunshot residue. What do you mean, dude? Okay, that's bullshit, dude. What the fuck?
I have no idea what you said.
He's memeing.
Oh.
Yeah, from here. Yeah. All right. Yeah, you're actually gonna shoot.
Okay. Oh, shit. Yeah, I can do it. Let me try again.
Ooh! Shit!
All right. Okay. All right. And then I'm pretty much screwed.
Yeah. If they try to bring it back, like they're trying to pull back. Yeah. All Tell me what you want. What do you want me to do?
Oh, give me money.
I got you first. He tried though. He did try. That was close. We run that back in slow motion. You'll see. That's one pink.
He's like half joking, but he's very serious about this stuff, for the record. Like, because there was a guy, there was like a fucking jujitsu kid or something that went, like, there was like a trained fighter guy who went and like kind of exposed him. So then he like made a very serious video doing an expose, a reverse expose on the other guy. To be like, actually, Urban Survival here, like, we have the full video here, and you were crying like a bitch, like.
Imagine two deals. Just two guys passing the gun back.
Or like one.
You didn't even shock him a little bit.
Yeah, they're just like flipping over and over again. Wop, 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 wop. Yeah.
I feel like that Resident Evil clip.
His entire fucking vibe is off of Resident Evil, straight up. That's like, they do like the... I mean, all of it, Dust is what it's called. Detroit Urban Survival Training, Dust.
D-U-S-T.
So, like, everything is like that.
Dude, I clipped. The clip was like, ready for it. He's like,
I know there's a second block. Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. Oh, dude, you're so... Yeah, you're right. Okay, wait, hold on.
I don't remember who it is. Gunfight?
It's like the classic... What was it? It was like two guys like shooting in the air, boom, 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 like shooting around each other and then fighting. What was it? It was like Gun Kata. Oh, this.
Yeah, this one.
This is incredible. Here, we'll speed it up to like the actual. Oh, here it is.
That's him. No, they're just.
This part is awesome. Dude, this is so anime. It's the most anime thing. They're just like fucking. It's like wushu. That's what this is. They're just doing wushu. But with guns. This is what happens when everybody gets the gun training. Yeah. Like, Dale,
oh,
Dale gave his training out to too many people. So why is he not a zombie?
I don't know. Why would he? Why would he be a zombie?
Synopsis: A Mexican army team supervised by BSAA Captain Chris Redfield investigates a mansion linked to a BOW smuggling operation, which is infested with zombies infected with a new viral strain. He finds Glenn Arias, a black market dealer wanted by the
Interpol. Haven't you already learned in like zombie stuff? It's always the real villains are always
the humans,
the people.
True. True. We are the villains.
This is the one that we critique heavily, the behind the back one.
I will be genuinely surprised if I don't pull this off, y'all. I want to be honest with you. Yeah.
Alright, I'm your hostage. Take me where you want to go. This is usually what you do with HR. That's pretty good.
Wait, so just want to be back up.
I will use my Dillman skills in that one. That one right there, I just play that.
Count in the back.
And it would just drop.
Oh.
Well, he gave like a kind of shitty explanation for why like people come up close to you when they're robbing you, because he's like, oh, because I don't trust them. Okay, except you would shoot them anyway. Like, you would just, if you don't trust them, you would just shoot them, you know, because so that doesn't make sense. I don't think anyone would like come up that close when they're robbing you. Only in movies do they do that, and the reason why they do that in movies is because, you know, you can fight back. Yes, I know Gunkata. I know.
Why should father be more real?
You know what Gunkata is, right? Have you guys ever seen Equilibrium?
No.
Oh my god. Okay, this is a cult class. I mean, you guys weren't born when this movie came out.
Exactly.
So, like, but it's one of my favorite movies of all time. And here, this is Gunkata.
Oh. Oh. Shit. Not without incident.
So good.
I can't believe they copied John Wick.
Good one.
Ooh. How did they miss?
He's hot.
It's one of the best. Is this how you play? Is this how you play Apex?
Yes, sir.
That's literally how you play Apex.
Fucking aimbot, dude.
Oh my god.
Oh yeah, he's got the automated reload, dude. Auto reload.
Why don't they just build the gun?
Other two dudes just staring at the other side, by the way.
They didn't hear it.
I love that. I love that the NPCs on the other side of the door were just standing and looking at these.
It wasn't in their aggro zone.
Yeah. That's wonderful.
You didn't get the aggro.
I mean, how would you shoot that? I'd be terrified if I saw someone doing backflips.
Like that. Yeah.
The first time I watched the movie was with offline chat. Dude, it's one of the best, dude. I love this movie so much. I'm going to rewatch it, actually. Okay, let's keep going.
let's step back so I can lead you somewhere. All right,
take me hostage, like grab me up so you can move me against my will, yeah.
All right. Ooh, oh, shit.
Here.
Boys, I'm screwed.
There's a medulla shot right there.
Yeah.
All right. Medulla.
Now, I'm going to resist a little harder.
Yeah, Caleb, I thought you were good at this.
Back of the head.
He forgot he could fire again.
He didn't go for the eyes.
Did he shoot it?
I just popped up. Eyes in a soft way. In a more realistic way, you would actually remove the eyes.
So, for the behind the back, though. So, here, Caleb, use the... We'll do this, I guess. I feel like if you were leading someone, you'd be more behind them. So what would you do here?
They'll just run away. They're not going to let you do that. So a SEAL team guy.
I love his running. Like, look, he's not the most athletic man. Look at him running away. Watch.
I feel like if you were leading someone, you'd be more behind them. So what would you do here?
They'll just run away.
That has emo potential.
Oh, that's awesome.
They're not gonna let you do that. So a SEAL team guy told me that he did this, and he would hold the person and extract it from the house like this. Because if you don't control the person, they will simply run away.
Well, there's no.
Yeah, but didn't you shoot them?
Well, stop! You're messing
you're calling
with his
their bluff.
Training.
That's the thing. They don't want to shoot you.
What? Okay.
Play with him.
If they don't want to shoot you, then running away is better.
Yeah, exactly.
Because if you actually, like, attempt to disarm them, they're definitely going to shoot you, possibly on accident.
Uh-huh.
So technically, running away would even be better in that situation. Anyway.
The way they survive, that's it, right? Like, you have a shotgun on somebody.
You get a lesson with
them. Fucked, right?
Well, again, you would have to, number one, have the intention to shoot.
True.
If you are professional, you'd have to have the legal reason to shoot. Or if you're surrounded by other officers or civilians and the person runs, you can't shoot because your field of fire is not clear. Right, so there's lots of reasons why a professional wouldn't shoot. When a person has the person
Who's a professional? Like, what does he mean? Like an assassin? Like, if there's an assassin.
A professional hitman?
Like, what do you, like a professional robber? Is that what he means? Because I don't think a professional robber gives a shit. I don't get it.
That's from the rear. They could pick up running.
Wait, is he teaching how to, like, escape cops? Is that what he's trying to teach?
I thought he was teaching how to survive robberies.
Also, cops definitely shoot if you run. Like,
that's true.
That's a 100%. Like, I can't speak for the criminal community, but I can tell you, cops 100%. Oh, he made a second video of him explaining him getting owned.
This is editing, though.
Yeah, no, he's. Dude, I love this man so much. All right.
They usually probably are getting away. Now that they go around telling people, hey, I ran away from someone with a gun behind me yesterday, right? But the reality is, it's just really hard to shoot someone moving laterally. It takes a lot of training. So the reason why you have to have contact when you have a weapon is because they will leave, or in the case of initial contact, because you want to limit what they can do: guns, knives. They can grab a chair. They can grab a weapon. Grab a brick. There's a lot of things they can do to attack you.
Yeah. Let me do the shotgun into a tank. My eyes pretty.
Let me see.
How fucked is it right now?
Stop Caleb for us, real quick.
All right. So let's do one. Do third person rescue. Stopping an active shooter. There's the. If I try to do anything, you're gonna fire that gun. Okay?
Yeah, I gotta be honest with you. I got him here.
You do?
Yeah.
I gotta be completely honest with you, Dale. Right,
if I try anything, you can see me in the mirror.
Yeah.
Oh, you blocked it.
You did the
yeah, there's a human wall here.
Yeah, right. The dancing area. If I try to do anything, you're gonna shoot the gun. Okay.
You shot the gun.
I think you shot yourself. Well, I tried to go like this.
He was. He was really trying. He was really trying. So all you internet experts, he knew it was going to happen. He is a talk.
how the fuck would like a school shooter let you get that close behind?
Shoot the gun. Okay?
What are you, like the school shooter's best friend or something? Like, how are you?
Just avoid his aggro range.
Yeah, if you're in the presence of a school shooter, stand very close behind them within striking distance. School shooters, they have this like weird thing where they can't sense when someone is directly behind them. No, this is the demonstration only for the professional assassin.
You have to unlock the skill point. You can't do this yet if you're an amateur.
I think you shot yourself.
Well, I'm trying to go like this.
He was really trying. So all you internet experts, he knew it was going to happen. He is a tough guy. This guy's actually strong and athletic guy, a wrestler, and I'm telling you, most people have been thrown onto their face with that. Just a little bit of pressure I put right there, they slam down.
Look at Caleb's eye.
Ready? I'm ready when you are.
Oh, your eyes.
If he just took him down.
This is adorable. He's going full wrestling mode.
No, I'm not actually hurt. My eyes do hurt, though. I'll tell you that much.
Yeah,
so his body to write this.
He's getting pissed. You can tell. Dude, I love that Charlie did like the baby mode where he was like, "Yeah, I'm just gonna put the gun on you," and he got lightly tapped twice, and he's like, "Yeah, fuck that. All right, time for the other dudes to do it." That's awesome. I can't wait for the third guy. I can't wait for the nightmare mode now.
When someone does gun, you have to.
He would have definitely got my eyes though, for sure. Yeah. If he wasn't holding back.
He was holding back.
Yeah, Caleb looks.
You look exactly the same.
Well, I'm not going for eyes.
Yeah.
It looks normal.
He's gonna make a video explaining this video 100%. Oh yeah, there's gonna be a rebuttal. Like, all right, Dale from.
What happened?
Dale from Detroit Survival here. I made him cry like a bitch. I made Caleb cry like a bitch. They didn't put that in the video.
Yeah, that's fine. Wait, is that like... I legit lost vision in my right eye, though.
Like, I broke my right arm, so who gives a shit that I broke my left?
That's what... Yeah, exactly. It's the same with eyes.
What?
That's first movement.
Still got it.
Good? You had to think about it.
That's only shot once.
So when we do the full disarm?
Only shot once. With this.
It's like MacGruber.
Why is he wearing a bow and lava?
I think he wanted to hide his face.
Yeah, he's in all the videos.
Oh, he's in other videos of his?
Yeah, he does all like the gun stuff for Charlie.
He's the gun friend.
Yeah, he's the gun guy, gun pro.
Interesting dude.
Nobody is gonna have eyes. I just want to point out, Rex still has his eyes. I'm pissed.
You made an agreement prior to our arrangement, which you failed to do.
I get it.
Only wearing the vest?
Let me see your taxes.
You said, let me see your taxes.
You just shot him twice already.
I'm the IRS. You said criminal. I don't know.
This man is a libertarian, okay? This is definitely a libertarian gun weeb right here.
He's a white collar criminal.
Yeah. I know you avoided tags.
Are you wearing this vest in real life? Do you wear this out in your?
I wear this at all times.
Okay.
This never comes off.
In the shower.
Shower.
With your wife.
I have a sleeping one.
With my wife.
Does your wife have one too?
Got it.
I have a sleeping version. It's a softer material.
All right. So you're a criminal and you're robbing.
Hey, what is your vest? Yeah.
Here.
And I'm going to show you what. I left my finger in the trigger guard on purpose.
Yeah, I'm going slow.
Because I want to show this. Because you don't show enough of this.
Yeah.
So a lot of people just zip their hand out. If you leave your finger in here, this. It does work. Okay. It hurts a lot.
So if we go here, push hard. This gives you leverage. So in a situation where law enforcement or a civilian.
Bro, this video is making it seem like Dale's ideas are respectable. I'm just gonna point that out there. If anything, it's making it seem like he actually is legit. I'm just gonna point that out there, okay? Do you not feel like that now?
I mean, it's because they...
It's so specific. Such specific scenarios.
I mean, they took away the scenario that counters him.
Which is
taking one step backwards, right?
Yeah, yeah, obviously.
Giving him, like, full control of the situation, kind of.
No, for sure. Especially because, like, you know, it's just very simple to just keep your distance.
Mm-hmm. Control the barrel of the weapon, you can control the entire gun. As long as you have this, you can control the gun. If you try to grab the hands, you can't control anything. You can actually drop back, yep. So the criminal will always have the upper hand if you grab the hands instead of grabbing the barrel. So
in your training, do they also teach you that same thing? Because I know that you...
No, they don't do that. This is for
criminals. This is, okay,
no police officer is going to be like...
All right, here's the thing about what I do and what this is for, okay?
Right.
My world is completely different than everybody watching this video right now, okay? I go into a restaurant, I know where I'm sitting, how I'm sitting, what I'm looking at. I don't sit with my back to the door. I don't put myself in any situation where I am at an extreme disadvantage. I probably wouldn't ever be in this scenario because I would be drawn before they ever come to me. And it's just that simple. However, people don't live their lives like that. They don't live in like condition yellow. They're all like kind of walking around like nothing's the problem. That's fine. However, this is a worst case scenario. Dale is absolutely correct when he tells you, hey, if somebody is threatening your life...
I mean, it could go either way. Either he's describing that he has PTSD, okay? Or he's like a libertarian LARPer guy. He said condition yellow. Jesus. It's called sitting in the combat seat. Hey, look, he's Charlie's friend. I'm not going to make fun of him.
Asking you for something, material possessions... Nothing is worth your life. Your credit cards, you can cancel them on your phone. They stole your phone, who cares? Okay? Give them whatever they want. If somebody is going to kill you, there is no question of material objects anymore. Now, when it comes to being in somebody's space, when he talks about like, hey man, what's up, let me talk to you real quick. This type of stuff is absolutely real. I deal with it all the time.
I have a former friend who actively thinks like this, and while not libertarian, turned out being an alt-right conspiracy theory follower. I mean...
Stuff that he's talked about with, like, wound channels. I've seen people get shot in the head at point blank and live.
And what shocking to see people live, wasn't it? Weren't you shocked? Like, wow, how can you live with a bullet in your head?
You never know. Just bullets do crazy things. Yeah. No, the bottom line is, this type of scenario...
Are you guys trying to leave? You can leave whenever you want. I'm sorry for keeping you guys here. You can just bail whenever.
All right, bye.
All right, peace. You're not gonna finish the video.
We have time. Well, like, we get to you finish the video.
Wow.
Yeah, we can watch.
You have to do that, you know.
Dude, are you guys just swagged out like this normally, or is this like a special occasion? Both of you look like fucking TikTokers right now.
He's a TikToker.
You look like...
I don't even have TikTok.
You look like, you know, fashion TikTokers. What is that? What's going on? Is there a special occasion or are you just like normally dressed like this?
Stepping out for today.
Wait, for real?
I mean, just pants, shirt. I mean, all this stuff.
Just pants
crazy.
And a shirt.
This is the best dressed I've seen Twitch streamers in any environment.
We don't go outside.
True. That holds weight.
Okay. All right. Let's just keep going.
I am a professional. I'm just gonna say it. I am trained. I would never do any of this stuff. Everything that I do is verbal commands, and I'm gonna take every precaution that I can.
He's 100% a cop, by the way. He's not a. I don't think he's like a Green Beret or anything. Or maybe he might have been. He might have been in the military, but he's definitely a cop.
Before I ever make contact with him, so this is strictly based on people with virtually no experience.
All right, so here's the training. All right, so someone pulls a gun and they put it in the vehicle, and the only reason they put it in the vehicle is
what? He reminds me of a dad who was just a LARPer. No, I don't think he's a LARPer. He's got like. He's got like fucking ex-military energy for sure. But I feel like he's a cop now, but maybe I'm wrong. Okay, let's see what he's going to do now.
And power and control over you. They could do it here, right? It's pretty scary. But this just feels so much better.
Right.
To put
what?
It on you.
Really?
And get this. I feel better about your fear right now. Oh, I'm liking it. I'm happy about this.
Right.
I feel powerful right now.
And wait, then you feel
very scared, like, oh my God. Now again, if you could just let him have the car, you would.
Right.
But you get the feeling like this guy is going to kill you, or he's not going to let you take your family with you. Like, hey, can I just get my kids?
My child needs to be protected at all costs.
Yeah. Yeah, he plays with the computer too much. This guy.
He does.
Son needs
I
to
can't
be with
get
you.
Him off. Cannot. Again. He's addicted at this
you
point.
Have to keep your son with you.
You should see how many Pokemon cards he buys.
Oh my God. We'll do here, we'll do here.
Okay.
Yep, you're in control.
All right. Wait, whose kids are we?
You're Dale's kids.
You're right. Papa Dale, save us.
You guys are
Dale.
Those kids, what a... Jesus. Oh, my fingers. That doesn't feel good. All right.
Same thing. If I try anything, he's going to shoot.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
You just killed his kid. you just killed your kids, Papa Dale. What the fuck? Yo, that's fucked up. Papa Dale's eardrum, gone. Okay? Like, killed his child, blew out his fucking ear. He's discombobulated. No shot. He has, like, any balance right now. He's probably fucking... I don't even know if we can see at that point.
Damn!
Jesus!
You
killed your
I will avenge you, son.
Oh my God.
Yeah. When disarming gunman, you still need your receipt belt.
Yeah.
Don't break
first.
The law. Click it or ticket.
So you don't know what's coming.
Yeah.
Right.
No, you got the gun on me. You're controlling me. Tell me to go wherever you want me to go.
Take me to the car.
Little Jimmy has a hole in him now.
There is absolutely nothing I can do to take that gun back.
What do you want?
I just want you to take me to the nearest gas station.
Okay, no problem.
I got you. I mean, you don't claim that they're 100% effective anyway. It just gives you a best chance.
Well, all you're doing is increasing, decreasing likelihood of survivability, right? Like a seatbelt. Yeah. You know, you're increasing or decreasing. Like, if you don't have a seatbelt on, it's going to increase survivability.
Why is this?
That was a lot more painful when he did it compared to when you did it, Matt. I'll tell you
I'm
right.
I'm shocked. I can't believe that.
This stuff actually hurts. Doesn't
that
crazy?
Didn't feel good at all.
When you're roaming the streets of Detroit.
Dude, Charlie looks like he just does not want to do any of this, okay? He's like, it's my video, so I have to appear in it. But also at the same time, it's kind of obvious that he is... He wants to pull a David Dobrik in this one. He's just like, I do not want to fucking... I'll put the other homies up front. You know, they can try to duke it out with Dale.
Right now, do criminals see Dale and just like turn and run from whatever they're doing?
They come up like, hey!
Like, walk down the street.
They got a selfie! Let's get a selfie, man! I love your video! I stopped robbing people last month just because of you.
I turned away from crime. I'm straight and narrow now.
Man.
Charlie, you gotta come try these so I don't have to hold it again.
My shoulders
out, so. No, you should come try. You'll love it.
Yeah.
Oh my
the
God.
The pain is good. It's a
I'm
good,
never gonna
it's a good pain.
Commit crime.
I love the jet ski, Dale!
The jet ski.
The jet ski in the back.
You can have it.
Oh.
Ooh. Okay.
Are you a convert, Charlie?
I'm not convinced a normal person's gonna pull it off that efficiently. But if you're going for Dale, I think he's got a good chance.
But you have to admit,
he's got
the
a
basics
mustache
of that.
The car alone.
I think that
if you see the mustache, you know what time it is. Especially the ID earpiece.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you see bone conduction, this is okay. First of all, this is not from Star Wars. This is not from Star Wars.
Bone conduction is pretty sick.
This is bone conduction. This is the future.
What?
God.
Would you
start
right?
wearing that?
What the
ask.
Fuck? Is it like speaking into his bones? Like, what does that mean?
He can read the future through the vibrations in his bones.
It doesn't go in his ear. It just like speaks through the bones. Those are like 25 years old.
Time to go.
You got Uber's here?
Yeah.
All right, bye guys.
Bye-bye.
Thank you for bringing my PC back.
I will need it back.
Yeah, of course. I just needed it for the week when they're fixing the studio, building the studio.
You got your...
What?
Helmet thing. Did you get the full suit?
Oh, the whole suit.
No, I just think... Yeah. They only sent a helmet, not the full suit. Thank you, Aesu and Doodoo Daphne, for coming over.
Thanks for having us. Appreciate it.
That was a lot of fun.
Tell yourself.
No!
What?
I can't believe you murdered a mosquito, dude.
That was
you
his
have
head.
Another one. There's another one in there.
Okay, good. All right, we're back. What? Shut it. It's fine. Okay. You can also put a pitchfork to your skull and hear it inside of your head.
This man,
just that working. I don't think so. I haven't earned it.
It's bone conduction. So you're gonna shoot if I try to do something.
Oh, sorry, it's Danny. Text. You're dead.
And then we have the gun here.
Text.
No, you don't.
Text.
wait, hang on here.
After her appearance on the Hassan Abbey broadcast, 39 Dad was last seen on January 23rd, 2022. We believe she's running away from the cops because of her several jaywalking offenses. If seen, do not hesitate to call 911. True. The Libertarian's gun handling skills are actually too good for him to be a cop, maybe. Make a fine point. Continue.
Single leg takedown. Just hurting Caleb this morning.
You come here to the bones. And push back.
Oh.
It seems like the most important thing you can do as a criminal is wear like goggles.
You would need a helmet.
I'm gonna get some steam. I'm gonna wear just a welding helmet, honestly.
Yeah, that's what we needed. Definitely something like that.
So this, and I'm sure. So there was a viral video, and there was a guy who went to his course like a month ago.
Like his demo. He demoed. He didn't go through the course. He just came to.
Ooh, he's addressing it. That's interesting. Okay. It's crystals for cops. Listen, the only thing that needs to be addressed on the stream is the top of the hour ad break, where there's a 60-second ad break at the top of every hour. And if you no longer want to see those ads, all you need to do is subscribe, baby. Yeah, that's right. You can subscribe for $5. You can subscribe for free with a Twitch Prime. Or you can, you know, get gifted a sub. That is, if you're lucky. If not, you make your own luck by subscribing on your own. Okay? Here's the 1 minute ad break now. Dude, he's got an iPad watch. Also, I'm going to pee.
He just came for one day.
Okay. So
for a free class.
Okay. Yeah. And then he was backing up, shooting on the way.
Right.
So in that situation... there's not a whole lot you can do, right? So if someone's coming at you...
No. So we were right here, okay? And so what happens is you're the robber, and you're going to back up, and you're going to pull the trigger, right, if I try to grab the gun,
right?
Okay? So you're the robber. What do you want?
I want your wife and kids. Oh, my God. All right.
So it's never going to change, and it didn't change for him.
Well, that's not fair. You've seen Charlie run. We know he's not getting away.
So that's what happened in the video that you saw. Now, what you saw later... when he backed up and did that, is what he did was he went like this. First of all, he'd already tried that. And what I just did to you, right, is exactly what happened to him. There was people in the room. So there's seniors back here, there's kids over here. So we're not gonna be doing a full on gun disarm with people over here training. So we're just doing the basic, you know, gun disarm. I said, well, you know, you can back up. You're still gonna lose the weapon. So what he did was he backed up on the second one, and then he shot like right here, and then I went in and took the gun from him. He edited the film, so that part's not there. So it just shows like he goes like this, boom, on the second one, and then it cuts.
Because I feel like, and I've said this before too, here, we'll do it this way. No, you can face me. Like, so if I'm a criminal and I'm like super anti, super trigger happy, if I'm just faster and I see you move and I am
faster. You can't see me move. You just saw it. Like, look, we'll do it again.
Well, hold on, not on me though, because that hurt.
Caleb's faster, you're probably more efficient, I think.
I could have slipped one.
My argument is my action is a lot smaller than your action.
Right. And that's,
so I have an increased percentage.
Right, you think that's possible. Not possible. Watch, put it up there. So what you're doing right now is you're concentrating on what?
Shooting. Because right. I intend to kill you.
Yeah. So that's not going to happen. Is it that? Right. And so now I'm anticipating you're trying to pull back instead of actually rob me or something, which mm-hmm. that's what this is for. And so from here, it wouldn't matter.
Hey, Charlie from the future here. This is one of those situations where I feel like I just wasn't fast enough, nor was Caleb, to actually make it work. This is one of those situations I feel is quite unrealistic, where you're assuming the victim is as fast as Dale, whereas the attacker could very well be able to react to your movement. The guy in the video is a jiu-jitsu student, so he's already pretty trained, so he's definitely got quicker reaction speed than we do, and I feel like this would always happen if you were just going up against someone faster, where they can just back up and pull the gun away, as it happened in that video, and there's nothing you can do. You're just chasing them getting shot the whole time.
So one of the reasons why people say, well, they'll say things like, oh, I could use the other hand. Okay, now that's true, except when a person has a weapon, they really believe in the weapon. So that's why you hear, you don't really see people have a pistol and go, oh, they're good.
It's because they're not smart.
They're good.
I'm 6'2", that was a good kick.
That was nuts.
They can come up and go,
is like the cop version of Neil deGrasse Tyson? No, dude, Neil deGrasse Tyson has more legitimacy than that. Random people mugging you don't want to kill you and he's teaching robbery defense? Yeah, random people that are mugging you don't want to kill you, which is precisely why it's better to just give them everything you have and let them get away. The best defense against a fucking robbery is by giving them everything you want, everything they want. Okay? Like, you're ridiculous. The best defense, like, the thing that you learn from this man, if you tried to do in a robbery situation, you 100% have a likelihood of an accidental misfire that ends up killing you or the other person or someone else, okay? He's right. Like, he I mean, I guess he's not right, but my point is, this shit is I think, technically way worse because, like, one, I don't think robbers will come up to you and, like, literally fucking put the gun in your body, okay? I don't think they ever would do that. And considering that they are not going to do that, you know, you making sudden movements is probably going to scare them into shooting you.
A good kick.
Whoa, I kick you in the face. Okay, right, but right. Reality, guess what? Right? They could. They could start with a pistol here. Like, right? But in reality...
So I have a scenario for you, Dale. I want you to role play with me right now. Mm-hmm. All right? You're out with your wife. You went to Troy. You're in Somerset Mall. Okay? You just went shopping. You had a great time.
Yeah, you know this area.
Yeah, of course. And I'm an armed assailant. I got shots. How are you
disarmed? I,
goes over and grabs a gun. You gotta grab a gun.
Have fun dealing with the self-defense trial. I'd rather give up my wallet. What? Yeah, I mean, it's not even have fun with the self-defense trial. Have fun fucking dying.
Are you guys perhaps in a sewer with a rat and some mutant turtles by any chance?
What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do?
Are you gonna let my brothers know that I have